Hola, ¿qué tal? Soy Paula. If you're new here, welcome. Don't forget to subscribe and to hit the notification bell. Today, I'm giving you my top 6 tips for learning Spanish. I already know that you want to learn Spanish, and that's why you're here, right? But let me ask you something, and this is tip number 1. What do you need it for? What's your goal? And I know it sounds cliche, but that's where you should start. Taking a look to a bigger picture. Why do you want to learn Spanish? Maybe for traveling, so you want to communicate freely with people from all around the world. Or maybe you want to get a better job, and you know that if you speak Spanish, you're opening more opportunities. Or maybe you have a business, and you want to expand it international and talk to your Spanish native clients in their own language. Or you are moving to a Spanish-speaking country and you don't want people to think you are uneducated because you speak a broken Spanish. Or you just love languages and Spanish is on your list. Whatever your goal is, you need a strategy. You need to figure out all you need to do and all the steps you have to follow in order to accomplish your goal. And that leads me to tip number 2. Think about your current situation. Do you have a full-time job and you get home pretty much exhausted? Or you're a student and you have free time available? Or maybe you have your own business and you get a flexible schedule? Or you are a mom who works and takes care of the kids and the house? Or maybe you are someone who has a lot of free time. Based on that, think about how many hours you can spend studying and when. Is it on Mondays? Is it on Fridays at evening? Is it on weekends? Write it down, stick to it, and take it seriously. You have to make it a habit, and for doing that, I highly recommend you to start slowly, but be consistent. Consume the language in small chunks, otherwise you're going to get overwhelmed easily. And what I mean by small chunks at a time is tip number 3. Make a small and specific goals. If you happen to have at least 40 minutes a day, that's fantastic. Create a plan that might help you to study throughout the week. But if you don't have that time every day, you have to determine your priorities. What's the most important to you right now? Is it a grammar point? Which one? Present, past, conditionals, future? Is your listening skills? Is it your speaking skills? Is it vocabulary? What? Adjective, verbs, adverbs, linking words? You gotta be specific. And once you define your priorities, go to tip number 4. Now that you know what's your specific goal for that day, week, or month, you gotta practice in an active way. Let's say you're studying grammar that day. Just by learning the rules and memorizing them is not enough. Because remember, a language is not only knowledge, but also a skill. An effective way to practice is by using your own experiences. I mean, you always can make up stories and you can always make up sentences, but if you can't relate your own life experiences with whatever you're studying, is going to create a link in your brain that relates a knowledge with a life experience. So you have to make it personal as much as you can. Or maybe you're listening to a podcast or a song or a TV show. Do active listening. Let's say your goal is to master the past tense. Listen carefully the way the show, the song, or the podcast is using that grammar point. Do that and you will see a difference in not only your results, but also in the satisfaction you gain from your learning. Tip number 5, make mistakes. Yes, make mistakes. Don't be afraid of speaking. Don't be afraid of messing up. Take every mistake as an opportunity to grow. Let's say you made a mistake once, twice. The third time you are about to make that same mistake, you are going to be able to correct yourself. And that's the moment when you own the language. That's the moment when you improve. So make mistakes. Mistakes are welcome. And if you get stuck, stop. Think about why you got stuck. Was it because a grammar point? or you couldn't come up with a specific word, or maybe it was lack of confidence. Whatever it was, write it down and next time work on it. The last tip I have for you today is to repeat. Repetition, repetition. Repetition is key to become skilled in whatever you're learning. And if you feel overwhelmed, stop and take a break. Not a long break, of course. There's nothing wrong in taking a break. In fact, it helps your brain to sink all the information you have learned so far. Let's recap. Identify your goal. Study your situation. Determine your priorities by making small goals and specific ones. Do an active practice, make mistakes, and repeat. All right? Now I want to hear from you. What's your weekly plan for studying Spanish? Let me know in the comments down below. That's it for today. I hope you liked this video. Don't forget to subscribe, to hit the notification bell, and to give me a thumbs up. I'll see you next time in the next video. Ciao!